I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God of God, light of light, true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, who knew all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, from the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified on Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us place all of our needs as the church, the Heavenly Father.
We begin by praying for the whole church, for all believers, that we may be open to grow in our understanding of who Jesus is and what he asks us to do each and every day. Let us praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father, we pray for the strength of commitment to serve as peacemakers in this world that's deeply in need of peace, in need of unity. We praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For minds that are open to new information and increased understanding about who Jesus is. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the increase in peacemaking across the world, as we seek to end wars and rumors of wars, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who struggle to believe, who are locked in rigid views, who preclude growing in faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And Father, we especially pray for space in our own lives that allows us to ponder serious questions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
In thanksgiving for parents and teachers, for catechists and pastors, for all who work to nurture the faith of children and youth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those whose faith is impeded by hunger, by poverty or abuse, illness or depression of any kind, pain, especially those within our community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray especially this morning for the repose of the soul of Ruth Bullock. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Now we pause that you may include your prayer of special attention this morning.
God, who sent Jesus to be with us, we are grateful for all we know about him. Help us to be open to all we have yet to learn, and strengthen our faith as our understanding grows. We ask this in the name of him, who you call your beloved Son. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
sacrifice of yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
The Lord accepts the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the law of his holy church.
Sanctify, Lord, we pray, these offerings here made to celebrate the glorious transfiguration of your only begotten Son. And by his radiant splendor, cleanse us from the stains of sin through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
He is right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he revealed his glory in the presence of chosen witnesses, and filled with the greatest splendor that bodily form, which he shares with all humanity, that the scandal of the cross might be removed from the hearts of his disciples, and that he might show how the body of the whole church is to be fulfilled, what so wonderfully shone forth first in its head. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy.
Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, only
received, and Lord, we pray, transform us into the likeness of your Son, whose radiant splendor you will to make manifest in his glorious transfiguration, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
See, for just a moment, we have a second collection.
Everybody in America, please be seated for a moment. Thank you, Father. I remember that first Saturday that we had a great Tuskegee. But we always enjoy having young people coming in to show other young people what can be done. So it's better for them to say it for us older people to say it. They don't believe what they say. It's definitely going to announce the birthday first Sunday of August. It's a joy to be here. It's a blessing to be here. Thank you for having me. Thank you for putting up with a long sermon. And I just ask that you keep vocations in your mind and prayers. May this be something we talk about more frequently. And let us all just be open to the next step that God has for us to use us as his light in the world. Amen?
Amen.
All right, let's stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you. May God bless you, Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Before the Mass is ended, our closing hymn is number 202.